So what do you guys want to do? Do you want to stamp first and then talk, which is what we typically do? Or do you want to talk about Chic and Clique first and then stamp? I'm going to let you guys decide. I will warn you, I've only had 4 hours of sleep. And over the past 2 weeks, I have not slept much at all. So I'm not feeling very, very creative. You want to talk? Okay, that's one. Okay, so who has questions? I did get a handful, actually, of emails from people that were thinking that I was no longer going to be posting on my ChicnScratch blog. So let me start out by saying ChicnScratch is staying the same. There will be no changes. I may not post as often, but it's not going anywhere. I love to blog. My forum is just an addition to what I'm already doing, kind of like an online class. So there's tons of online classes going on. I've always wanted to do a forum. I mean, seriously, I became a demonstrator in 2002. I probably logged on to Split Coast Stampers either that year or the following year, and I have always wanted to have a forum of my own to organize and to have people that I can talk to and people that's on my side. But anyway, I've always wanted one, and I tried to start one in 2011, and then that's when Chase had the bone tumor and I had the thyroid cancer and all of that. So God just had a plan for me later. And I tried another membership site in 2011 also, because again, it's something I've always wanted. So anyway, long story short, this is just something I've wanted to do, and now is the time. I'm not getting any younger, and I work really hard. I will put 100% of my time into making everyone happy and to showing really cute projects and doing everything I can. So there's not going to be any changes to my regular blog. I'm just adding something addition. Okay, so are there any questions about that? I know I tried to reply to the ones that sent me the actual emails and said, no, I'm not quitting my blog. I love my blog. Thank you for the happy birthdays. It's exactly like, and it's different from what everyone else's looks like. Like, it's like, it doesn't even look like a forum when you log in. It's so different. That's the great thing about it. Thank you, thank you. Okay, so the reason I'm holding this here, so let me tell you my thoughts, since I am somewhat wiped out. When I finally figured out how to make this box, those of you, oh wait, let me ask this really quick. How many first timers do we have here, number one? And number two, if you guys have a question, use the chat box. You can just create a free account with Ustream, and then you can use the chat box. Awesome. Okay, so who is new? Any new timers, listen to me. Any new people? First timers, that's what it's called. Welcome. One? Just one? Come on, there's got to be somebody else. Okay, well, we're happy that you're here. Hopefully I won't chatter too much. I probably will, because like I said, 4 hours of sleep is brutal. Stephanie or one of my downline girls, do you guys have access to the social stream? I'm afraid to move over from the chat box, and I really don't want to ignore the social stream people. Okay, give me one. If anybody on the social stream has a question, you're welcome to text me. I'm sorry, I still have not figured out the social stream part. Okay. A bunch of happy birthdays. Can I explain the difference between the two memberships? Absolutely. I would love to explain the differences. Okay, so the regular membership, which is $8 a month, that is going to be just a regular membership where I'm just going to be posting new projects every week. Like I said, there's already 13 new projects on there. I don't really have a specific number that I'm going to post. I really don't think a number matters, because I think that if, like, for example, if it was this box, maybe this box would be a project for 1 week, but then maybe the next week I'd post three or four. So I don't really have a number. So there's the videos, there's the photo gallery, there's the forums. Yeah, so those three things. So that's the basic membership. The premium membership actually gives you a separate forum where you will have more direct communication with me. Like, for example, I have checked the Ask Angie forum like literally every 15 minutes. Because you guys know, like, seriously, I have two phones, iPad, laptop, everything, all my electronics are all over the place. They're all around me, even in bed. No, I'm kidding. So it will have that, the Ask Angie section. And then also all of my previous membership sites and everything, which is over 120 videos, all of that content is going to be on the premium side. So all my online classes, all my attempts at virtual clubs and that kind of thing, all those videos, even though the product, some of the product is retired, not all of it, the projects are, I think, were super cute. So all of those videos, yeah, it's just $4 more. But really, there's no, you didn't miss anything, Debbie. You're fine. I was a little bit late, too, because the hardware or software was updating. I should just bank on that every time. What was I saying? Anyway, I think that everyone's going to be really happy. I know I really focused on getting, I wanted a lot of new videos as soon as people logged in. So like I said, that's 13 projects. Boom, instantly when you log in today. I have a couple more lined up for next week. But then the week of spring break, I might not post any because this month there'll probably be 20 videos loaded. The photo gallery right now does not have hardly anything because the photo gallery is going to be a combination of all of us. So it will be your projects and my projects. That's not limited to me. But I am going to start loading like my swaps I got at Leadership. I can't wait to get those loaded because they're so awesome. I participated in a couple really good swaps, so you'll be excited to see those. If I happen to miss, wow, it is really thundering. Holy cow. Now I'm like freaking out. Should I go unplug all my computers? Well, let's make this project because I might be getting out of here quick. If I hear a bolt of lightning, I got to get out because all my devices are plugged in, even my Ustream stuff. Okay. I got my Simply Scored scoring tool. Back to the project. You guys can ask me questions about Chicken Click. I'll be happy to answer them. I will love to answer them. But we're going to make this project really quick. Okay, so when I made this super cute box, I was thinking I would really like to make it small and make it an Easter project. Wouldn't that be stinking cute? So again, like I said, I like figuring out how to make things different during the live streams. It just kind of challenges me. The other day, I was attempting to make a box, and I swear, I think I went through 12 pieces of paper. I finally just said, forget it. Today is not my day. So we're going to figure out how to make this project half the size. I think I kind of sort of know, but I'm not real sure. And I don't remember if when I did the video originally, if I even included the template. I kind of think I didn't. Am I talking too fast? Can you tell I just had an entire cup of coffee? Yeah, I don't know what I was doing. Yes, you can post pictures. You can post projects. There will be no linking and no watermarks, though. For the first year, those will be the rules. We will reevaluate in a year because right now this is going to be a safe place for demonstrators and customers. And I suspect that I will have as many of both. So the first year, no links, no watermarks. But other than that, I want to see everyone's projects. In fact, we have our first sketch posted today. We're going to have a bi-weekly sketch. And all 24 sketches are done. All the PDFs are ready. They're easy to do. I'm so excited, and I had one of my downline girls, Sally, help me do it, and she's awesome at organizing stuff. Oh, I think it's Haley now. So anyway, the sketch challenges. So if you were a fan of the Definitely Sketches program that I did, you'll like the Chicken Clique sketches for sure. You know, I may offer a trial down the road. The thing about trials is that trials are more for people that don't already know you. I mean, if you guys, after 7 years of blogging, you don't know the content that I offer or the projects that I make, yeah. So I may offer a trial at some point. And yes, you can cancel at any time. It's a recurring thing. You just log in and cancel. And there's no hard feelings. What was I going to say? Yeah, I mean, most people know me in this industry. I didn't just start out with a paid subscription site without ever blogging for free. I mean, I'm getting closer to 600 free videos on YouTube, so woohoo! And I just reached 35,000 subscribers. Yes. Okay, I'm done tooting my own horn. I promise. So here's what I'm gonna do. Let's see. Oh my gosh, it's hailing. Seriously, it's hailing. Okay, I said that already. We're going to make this in... Oh, I grabbed two sheets of the wrong color. We're gonna start with this one. I kind of have ADD, so the whole distraction of the hail hitting my window is, like, really messing with me. Like, badly. Okay, so looking at this template here. Okay, so if we wanted to make this half the size, I think all I have to do is technically just... I know some people probably say, oh, that's so easy, you just cut it in half. But yeah, my brain don't go that way. I have to do it. I have to touch it. So I think I'm going to take an 8.5 by 8.5 sheet. I'm going to go ahead and cut it at 8.5 by 8.5. And then I'm going to trim it down. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. Unless y'all suggest something else.
What was
it? Oh, I can't scroll in this chat box. If I miss a question, will you guys just please, repost it? You can hear the thunder. Can you hear the hail hitting the window right here? Oh dear. I did exactly what I thought I was gonna do. I moved the chat box. Sounds like popcorn. Yeah, don't say the word popcorn around me. I'm like dying for food. I'm on a diet. Oh, I'm not dying, but yeah, I'm kind of dying. Okay, so 8.5. I'm going to get this project. I'm fast. You guys know, once I start, I'll be done. Lickety split. So, 8.5 by 8.5. Bellaroo. Okay. So... we need this much. I want to see how far I want to go down. 4.5 by 4.5. Well, I couldn't figure that out. I have to keep the 8.5 going because these score lines, that would be way too much for my brain tonight anyway. Okay, so 1.5. So let's say I wanted it to be this tall, which that looks kind of cute. So I'm going to cut this at 6. So somebody write that down. 8.5 by 6. I hope I don't mess up like I did last time. Oh, by the way, the hail stopped. Okay. Oh, wait. What was her suggestion? Oh, 8.5. Oh, darn. I already cut it. That's okay. You're right. Maybe I do need it to... well, we'll be fine. So I'm going to score it on the 8.5 inch side, because that's this side that remained intact, at 1/2 inch, and then 1.5, 2 3/8, 4 5/8, 5.5, and 6 3/8. Okay, so y'all got that. So now, so you have the pen? One of you has the pen? Yeah, I've had several people email me and say they're like so afraid they're going to lose it, that it writes so good. I'm like, if you lose it or if your husband steals it, I'll send you another. Yeah, I love them too. Okay, so now I'm going to turn it and score it at 1.5 and then 1.5. I think this thing's going to be teeny tiny. I may have made a mistake. You were probably right when you said 6.5, but oh well. So now let's cut. Where's my scissors? See, I told you this project, we're going to be done by 9 o'clock, and y'all are going to be like, she was right. All that rattling, and she still got finished on time. Didn't y'all love the bag I posted today? Stephanie, I know you're on here. Who else am I downliner on here? If you order this month, you're getting that bag. You're getting a kit to make that bag for free. All my whole downline. Anyone that places an order in the month of March is going to get a kit to make that bag. I'm addicted to it. Plus, I got a ton of that paper. So I'm like, oh, that would be such an awesome gift. Okay, so I don't know if you guys remember this. Okay, so both of y'all, two of you, I thought there was more that was going to be on here. I hope I'm doing this right. I think I am. Who knows the date to Easter this year? Okay, one more spot. Oh my gosh, this is going to be so perfect of a size. I swear, I think it is. Oh, somebody today said, oh, I was so happy to see your ATG tape gun back. I'm like, I know. I love it so much. Okay, wait. Let's make sure I do this right. I don't want a crooked box. Oh, April 20th? Wow, that's a late Easter. That's awesome. That means I got another whole month of showing Easter projects. I got two lined up for, I got two lined up for the next week or so. So, woohoo. Which side do I want to be the front? This one. So we're going to put adhesive on this one. Oh, wait, I forgot. Get the glue dots. Oh, they don't make one for the left-handed people? I'm sorry. Y'all get cheated on a lot of things. Because I hear that reference to, like the trimmer, for example. Isn't the trimmer another thing that they don't make for lefties? I'm always amazed by left-handed people, though. Like, if I'm watching a movie or whatever and I see lefties, I'm like, oh, that's so cool. Of course, y'all probably think the same thing about right-handed people. I don't know. Do you? Oh, you lost me. I'm sorry. Yes, it was 8.5 by 6. And look how stinking cute. Oh, my gosh. Yes, I cannot wait to show this on my blog. How cute is that? I knew it. Well, I didn't know it, but I kind of did. Where's my hole punch? Let me get it. Okay, another downline. You like this size better? Yeah, it'll be a lot easier to fill up with, well, not fill up. I meant like the other box, you had to put a lot of something in there to fill it up. Whereas this one, it's like, let me show you. Look, I got my nice little Easter candy here. So if we wanted to put some little Easter eggs in there, look, perfect. I'll take it back out. Okay, I wish I could eat one of those pieces of candy right now. I haven't really been explaining, but y'all all saw the big one, right? Next item to make for your ladies' brunch. That's awesome. It's so stinking cute. You can make this for like a baby shower, couldn't you? Oh, I gotta get some ribbon. And I'm thinking, how did I close that? Oh, I punched two holes. Sugar. Okay, well, let's see. For whatever reason, I was thinking I was going to do it another way, but maybe not. So I got to punch a second hole, right? Is that what I did? Yes. Now it's going to be off-centered. Well, let's do this. We'll punch. We have three holes. It's just a sample. You love making 3D? 3D's why I signed up. Okay, let's see. Do you do scrapbook pages or just, yeah, I don't do scrapbook pages. You know, the funny thing is that I actually started out as a scrapbooker. I sold Creative Memories for 5.5 years. I completed 17 albums. And then I was ready for breads and chalk and eyelids and all that stuff. So, yeah, I abandoned ship. Plus, they were doing that whole simple, simple, simple. Can't remember the name of it. Started with a P, I think. I didn't want to do simple. I wanted to use those eyelids. I remember hammering my husband's sleep, and he's like, "What the heck are you doing with that hammer?" Yeah, the measurements for the scoring are the exact same one as this one. Hey, can somebody over there check the social stream for me and see if there's any major questions? Pretty please. See, you won't even notice that there's a third hole in there. Because it's covered up with this fabulous ruffle trim. Whoops. Yeah, the score marks are the exact same ones. I just started with a smaller piece of paper. Designer series paper. This is so cute. I'm going to make a bunch of them too. Okay, so I'm going to go with something simple. So we got our Whisper White here. I think I need to grab an ink pad. And I've had a couple people request the Extra Spectacular stamp set. And the two Easter projects that I have lined up, of course, are using this little bunny. I love it. Like anything that can be, that can fit. I don't think I cleaned that ink pad. Anything that can fit in a punch or a framelit. That's my kind of stamping. This pistachio pudding before, I don't think. Yeah, no, I haven't. Isn't he cute? cute or she or whatever it. I bought this set just for that image, although I have used the other one on my Stamp Club Online, one of my projects over there, so. Isn't it cute? How can you not smile looking at it? Okay, did anybody look and see if there was questions? Oh, you used to do that with the hammer too? Yeah. I kind of miss those eyelets. They'll come back. That's why I'm not getting rid of them. I still have all of the Stampin' Up! Ones. I don't know if that's something I should really admit. Okay, I'm going to have to pierce the scallops. I could have used the... Well, you know what would have been cuter? Is if I had used the chalk marker. I think I have it right here. I do, because I used it in one of my other videos. I'm not sure which one. I'm not sure you're going to be able to see this. It's worth trying. Maybe you could see a touch of it. You're hooked on Stampin' after seeing this project? Woohoo! I really did join just for the 3D stuff. When I first saw Stampin' projects, they always had these cute bags. Like, yeah. That's cute. I kind of wish that this piece was white, but I don't think we have another piece. I really wish we had another scallop circle. Anyway, it'll be fine. I'm overanalyzing. I have ChicnScratch available. Woohoo! I'm so excited that I can sell them again. I can't even tell you. Like, I just was devastated when I had to stop, so. Look. Voila! Now, how cute is that going to look when you have a strawberry slush, a coastal cabana? What's the other colors? Crisp cantaloupe, and baked brown sugar. Okay, so, questions? See, I told y'all, it's 8:36. It's not even anywhere near 9 o'clock, and we're done. Of course, I did decorate it really simple. You can't get much simpler than that, but it's still stinking cute. Yeah, I could have. And I could have stamped the bunny in Black Stays On. And then, do I have problems with the DSP coming apart at the seams when you score and fold them? No. Are you scoring too hard? Maybe you're using, like when I score the designer series paper, I make sure that I use the larger tip one, and I use the smaller one on regular cardstock because our cardstock's kind of thick. I use this one only for designer series paper. What's the name of the stamp set? It's called Extra Spectacular. And I'd like to say that I knew where the stamp set was, the whole thing. It would be easier to probably show you the catalog. But I'm not even sure where that is. Like I said, I did 15 projects in 1 week, filmed 15 videos, edited 15 videos, and did the instructions and everything. That's on top of living, breathing, and eating. What are the Chic stands? The Chic stand is simply a paper piercer stand. It just holds it perfectly on your desk. It doesn't roll around. When I travel, I just stick it on the side in the side like that. It fits perfectly in my suitcase. It's just something I came up with. The name, ChicnScratch, is when I called my sister, she also helped me name Chicken Clique. So if you guys want to know how Chicken Clique and Chick Stand came to be, I called my sister and I told her what the product was, and she said, "Well, what is it?" And I'm like, "Well, it's a stand, you know, something you put a paper piercer in." And she's like, "A stand?" And I was like, "Yeah, you know, like a stand to stand up." And then we're like, "Oh, a bicycle stand, like a kickstand on a bike." So a chick stand for the paper piercer, like a kickstand for a bicycle. Anyway, we're girls. What can you say? Yes, my blog, my Chicken Scratch, is not changing. It's staying the same. Just like this week, I've already posted 2 free videos. I will continue to post free content. The Chicken Clique is just an addition to what I'm doing, not taking away anything. Okay, I gotta check this. Somebody's asking me a question. You can't read the first part of my email address. Oh, okay, so it's admin, admin, and then at mychickenscratch.net. So you can see my blog for how to spell my Chicken Scratch, and then just use .net instead of .com. Okay, so the next question is, oh, is this Michelle? Hi, Michelle. Thank you. Okay, I don't think there's any more questions on here. There's lots of text. How would I upgrade? You know, I really don't know. I'm not understanding your question. So are what projects not going to be on my blog? Like, this project's going to be on my blog. But the 13 projects that are already on Chicken Clique, no, they will not be on my blog. They're not for public. They'll only be, it's called paid content. Kind of like an online class. If you've ever taken any of my online classes, those are not posted on a live format or a public format. They're paid content only. Where do I get inspiration? Okay. I covered this a couple live streams ago. Do you want to, like, this box right here? Let me see if I can find my template real quick of where I got this idea. I've had this box ever since before Christmas, and I wanted to do it really bad, and I could not figure it out. And the top of this right here came to me in the middle of the night. Hold on, let me look. Okay, I don't know where it is. I showed it a couple live streams ago, though. It was a candy box. It was Japanese candy that my daughter got me at the Target dollar spot. And man, it was yummy. It was like this strawberry filled something, which totally gave me a stomach ache later. It clearly had dairy in it. But anyway, so the reason I couldn't figure it out is because I could not figure out how to do the top, because stampers, like, the only way I could figure out, like, okay, so for example, on that box that I got, or she got from Target, the top and the bottom were sealed. And I'm like, well, demonstrators do not want to make a box that they have to tear apart to get open. So I kept getting hung up on the fact that both the top and the bottom had to be sealed. And then all of a sudden, it was like, wait a second. In the middle of the night, I'm like, wait, I could bunch it up at the top and do it with a ribbon. So then I was like, whew, so stoked. So where do I get my ideas? Yeah, so like a Band-Aid box. I just see things. And it's funny because, like, the bag that I posted on my blog today, I came up with the bag. I've made that bag before a long time ago. But to decorate it with the paper doily with the Starburst Sands in the middle, I saw that at Leadership. Somebody had done that. And I'm like, oh, that's brilliant. Love it. Oh, why can't you see me? Ruh-roh. Which box do you think is easier to make for a retirement party? How many are you making? Are the projects for your premium club going to be all your new projects? I'm confused. I'm sorry. What do you mean? I think think the 2, 4, 6, 8 box is a really good retirement party, but what do you want to put in it? Because you can get 2 out of a sheet of cardstock. Yes, the projects on my on the club are all new. Quick goodie bags for a teacher. You know, I don't. I used, when my kids were in school, I did a lot of teacher gift stuff. And yeah, I you know what? I will definitely, I'm going to make myself a note. Think about, you mean like end of the year teacher gifts? I miss doing that. I used to make them all kinds of little things. I also used to bake a lot. I used to deliver a whole bunch of cookies. Okay, I cannot get this chat box to work properly. Oh. Somebody remind me next time to not touch the chat box. I seriously... Oh, I have one of those Cadbury egg things, by the way. Whoever said that earlier. I have one in the bag behind me. Okay, I think I'm getting to the current comments. Just hitting the down arrow button. Did I do anything special for my birthday? That is a hoot. Nope. I got up at... I had 4 hours of sleep. You know what? How can I say nope? Yeah, I did something really exciting. I launched my forum that I've always wanted to have. So, yeah, that was very exciting. My husband sent me roses because he had to go out of town. But it worked out perfect because I kind of work all the time. And I knew I was going to be working from sunup to sundown and more today. So it worked out great that he was out of town so he didn't have to be here to watch me spaz. And there was a period there for a while where the payment system wasn't working and I had people that were wanting to join and couldn't join and I was freaking out. And so yeah, it was a good thing he wasn't here. If you tape it, oh, the bag was awesome. It was amazing. Oh, yeah. Okay, so guess what? I'm kind of sort of thinking about doing a retreat. I know I've said this before, but then I was sick, too, before. So I talked to David this weekend about having a retreat in October. So I kind of sort of think I'm going to do it. He said I could. And the reason I want to do October is because I could totally do Halloween, Thanksgiving, and Christmas, which you guys know totally is right up my alley. I cannot see the latest comment, so I'm just basically rattling on. What the heck is this thing doing? Help! There we go. I don't know. Remind me, guys, next time when I do this to not touch the chat box, because every time I do, once I touch it once, it never works again. Like, it just gets stuck. Like, all I can see right now is the chat. Well, now I've completely lost it. Holy cow. What did I click on? Oh, there it is. Yes. Wish you were... Wish... daughter's birthday. Oh, tell her happy birthday. 28. Wow. Okay, if you're talking about me, I live in Overland Park, Kansas. So, yes, that would be where the retreat would be Overland Park. And we have a teeny tiny airport that's super quick and easy to fly into. You can never get lost in that airport. It's so small. And the flights are very reasonable. It's not cold here in October. Well, okay, wait a second. You're not coming here to lay out on the beach. You're coming here to stay out. We'd be in a nice cozy hotel. In our PJ Stampin'. You're talking about a retreat like a beach thing. Well, I'd love to go to Napa. Okay, let's see. A treat would be wonderful. Where would you have it? Yes, I would have it here in Kansas because all my stuff is here. There's no way I could have it anywhere else because, oh my goodness gracious. I have to pack the... Like, I'm an overpacker. When I go out of town, I have to pack 2 suitcases and 2 carry-on bags. So imagine if I were to have a retreat, like my whole office would have to go with me. Oh, I'm going to go have my apple and go watch some Heroes and hit the sack. Thank you. I love the new site too. Okay, have a good night. Thanks a lot.